Hi friends, very pleasant good evening to all. I welcome to all of you. Know Your Disease episode 1. Today I am going to discuss about the episode 1, hydrocephalus. First of all, definition of the hydrocephalus. It is the abnormal accumulation of CSF in the intracranial space. It occurs due to the imbalance between the production or absorption of the CSF or due to the obstruction of the CSF pathway. It results in the dilatation of the cerebral ventricles and enlargement of the head. There is a two type of the hydrocephalus, congenital hydrocephalus and acquired hydrocephalus. Congenital hydrocephalus due to the intrauterine infection, mainly especially the rubella, toxoplasmosis, cytomegalovirus, congenital brain tumor or intracranial hemorrhage. It may be due to the congenital malformation also. Malformation of the arachnoid villi may be possible. Now, what about the acquired hydrocephalus? It may due to the meningitis, encephalitis, trauma, birth injury, increase the intracranial hemorrhage, neoplasma, especially the chemical hypervitaminosis, degenerative atrophy of the brain or arteriovenous malformation. Now, we are talking about the types. Communicating hydrocephalus or non-communicating hydrocephalus. We are talking about the communicating hydrocephalus. In this type, actually there is no blockage between the ventricular system, the basal cisterna and the spinal subarachnoid space. There may be failure in the absorption of CSF, or we can say excessive production of the CSF, as in the choroid plexus papilloma. Now we are talking about the second type, non-communicating hydrocephalus. This type of the hydrocephalus, there is obstruction at any level in the ventricular system. The obstruction may be partially, intermittent or complete. Due to the inflammation and developmental obstructive lesion, it occurs majority of the cases. Now, generally what is the pathophysiology? The ventricular system become greatly distending and dilated, increase the intraventricular pressure, leads to thinning the cerebral cortex and the cranial bones. Due to this one, sub-epididymal edema occurs and while matter is compressed. Downward bulging of the third ventricle compresses the optic nerve. At last, choroid plexus is usually atrophied to some degree. Okay, this is the pathophysiology. Now, what is the clinical manifestation, or we can say what is the sign and symptoms? Generally, the children have a large head. Second one is bunging fontanelles. Or main important thing, there is a facial sign called Mason sign. The child who has a hydrocephalus, suppose you are percussing the skull anteriorly, posteriorly or posteriorly, you strongly get the resonance sound due to the accumulation of the CSF. This sign is called Mason sign. Vomiting is also there, sleepiness is also there, or there is a loss of the bladder control, loss of कॉन्सियसनेस, समटाइम ट्रबल वॉकिंग, जनरली लो ग्रोथ और सम रिस्ट्रिक्टेड मूवमेंट आर प्रेजेंट. नाउ कम टू द पॉइंट, हाउ टू इवैल्यूएट द चाइल्ड विथ हाइड्रोसेफेलस. देर इज सो मेनी डायग्नोसिस वी कैन यूज. फर्स्ट वन इज द फिजिकल एग्जामिनेशन, सेकेंड वन इज द न्यूरोलॉजिकल असेसमेंट, थर्ड वन इज MRI, मैग्नेटिक रिजोनेंस इमेजिंग, नेक्स्ट वन इज ए क्रेनियल अल्ट्रासोनोग्राफी और एक्सरे. नाउ व्हाट इज द मैनेजमेंट? एज वी ऑल नो देयर इज अ टू टाइप ऑफ द मैनेजमेंट इज देयर. फर्स्ट वन इज ए मेडिकल मैनेजमेंट, स्पेशली द टेबलेट डाइमोक्स. ओके, वी कैन गिव दैट इंक्रीज द इंट्राक्रेनियल प्रेशर. ओके, दिस मेडिकेशन हैज ए कार्बोनिक एनिहाइड्रेस इनिबिटर, स्पेशली ऑलरेडी आई मेंशन डाइमोक्स 50. ओके, इट विल रिड्यूस द प्रोडक्शन ऑफ द CSF. सेकेंड थिंग वी कैन से नाउ सर्जिकल मैनेजमेंट. इन द सर्जिकल मैनेजमेंट देर इज ए टू टाइप ऑफ द सन्ट्स अवेलेबल, विपिसंट, वेंटिकुलो पेरिटोनियल सन्ट, एंड सेकेंड वन इज ए वेंटिकुलो आर्ट्रियल सन्ट. वॉट विल हैपन? एक्स्ट्रा CSF आर एब्सॉर्ब इन द पेरिटोनियल कैविटी. दिस इज द सिंपल टू टाइप ऑफ द मैनेजमेंट आर प्रोवाइडेड टू द पेशेंट विद द hydrocephalus. This child should be taken bedrest. Especially you can provide them a nutritional diet, right? You should try to avoid them from the subordinate infections. Every day you can measure the intake output charts, or regularly you can measure the size of the head. Friends, I think you can get the brief about the hydrocephalus. Now I am going to wind up the session. If you have any query or any suggestion, kindly comment on the comment box so I can make a new video for you. Take care, stay safe, good evening, thank you very much, thank you.